Do you have competitors that get more search traffic than you? Do you want to beat them? Well, it all starts with keywords. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm going to show you how to find all the keywords that your competitors rank for that you don't. Now, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel. And if you're on YouTube, make sure you click the alert notification. That way, when I go live or release other videos like this, you'll get notified. So as you can see on my screen here, I have Uber Suggests loaded. If you want to go to Uber Suggests, just go to ubersuggests.com and you can type in any URL or keyword. Now I'm already in the app, I've already logged in, so I'm going to type in a keyword, or more so a URL, like neilpatel.com. This is my website. You can type in your website, and if you don't have tons of data, like tons of traffic, you can always type in one of your competitors' domains as well. And then I want you to go on the left-hand navigation and click on competing domains. This shows you all the similar sites that you're competing with. And some of these sites, you know, it's based on overlapping keywords. So the more common keywords you have, the more likely you are to be a competing website. So if you look at this graph here, Forbes, although they have a lot of articles on marketing, I'm going to take them off because they also talk about other stuff. Same with Entrepreneur. And now I have a better list of competing sites. And if you go into the More dropdown, you can see the list continually expand. So you can either subtract or add from there as well. When you look at this chart, I want you to actually scroll down. You'll see common keywords. This shows you how many keywords that you are ranking for that your competition also ranks for. But the goal here isn't to focus on those keywords because you're trying to outrank them. So what I want you to do is literally go through this list of all the ones that are, you know, very in-depth competitors and look for the keyword gaps. So the keywords gap is all the keywords your competitor ranks for that you don't. So here's HubSpot. If I want to beat HubSpot, what I would do is click View All. When I click View All, it'll end up pulling a list of all the keywords that HubSpot rank for that I don't. Now, as you can see here, there's literally a million keywords that they rank for that I don't. Some of these keywords, super lucrative, they make sense. Some of them, not so much. So let's go through them. How to change Messenger theme, don't care to rank for that. Should I get a real estate license? Again, don't care to rank for that. I'm gonna keep clicking next until I find some keywords that I believe would be valuable to my audience. Remember, not all your competitors will have keywords that are identical to what you want to be going after. So you need to really look through them and pick the ones that are super relevant. So for example, Grand Canyon puns, not a good keyword for me, but best real estate website designers, that's a good one because I can create a marketplace and make commission from that. Let's see, best company newsletter examples. That's a good example of a keyword that I should be ranking for as well, because if I rank for this, some of the people in there be like, this is a lot of work. Let me just go and pay Neil's ad agency, Neil Patel Digital, to do this for me. And I can just keep going next, next, next. And as you can see, as you keep clicking next, it pulls all the keywords, again, that your competition ranks for that you don't. And with this list, you know, if you want to make it simple, you could just export it to CSV so that way you don't have to keep clicking next, next, next. And then just pick the keywords that are great for you and delete the ones that aren't related to your business that you don't want to be going after. For example, I don't really care to go after money management software free, right? I don't care to go after free templates numbers or free numbers templates or Outlook calendar in Gmail or Google Calendar. So I would pick the ones that are the best, like NLP chatbots. That could be interesting because a lot of people that would be interested in that probably have sales teams and they're trying to figure out how to persuade people to convert into customers. As I mentioned, you can click the export button. When you click export, it just downloads all the keywords. May take a little bit if they have tons and tons of keywords. And then you wanna just go through and do this for all the competition. You know, here's Forbes. Let's actually go to WordStream. WordStream's probably actually a better fit because Forbes, again, has articles on everything, like on Amazon or accounting advice, and that's not really what my website is about. So I would go through this, I can download them all and export it to CSV, as I mentioned, and I can go after the keywords that are very relevant You know, like I may go after Gmail search shortcuts. You know, people who are marketers a lot of times do a lot of work in Gmail. So even though that article won't necessarily convert into a direct customer, it can let more marketers know about me, which can then indirectly increase my revenue. And how to use Instagram for real estate. I think that would be great because all those real estate agents could be potentially paying my ad agency, Neil Patel Digital, for work. And I would just go through this and I would ideally look for the keywords with high volume and high CPC, because that means lucrative keywords that can generate revenue. You know, diploma, digital marketing online, or if someone wants an online digital diploma, that's a lucrative keyword when it looks at $24.74 CPM. The volume isn't that great, but you can start going after keywords that have a lot of volume and high CPC. You just have to go through them. Now, I know this process looks like it's time consuming, but here's the thing. If you know your competition's already doing well and beating you, it's from the keywords that have high volume and high CPC, assuming they're related to their business and related to yours. And those are the ones I want you to make a list of and go after, and then go and create content around those topics. All the ones that are very similar, group them together. If some of these keywords match other pages on your site, but you just don't discuss that part, expand upon those articles and include those keywords as well. And if you do this, and you do this with, you know, one article a week, literally just one article a week based on new keywords that you're finding, after a year, I know that sounds like a long time, but it really isn't. You'll notice that your traffic will start growing by leaps and bounds. You know, all those little increments of 5-10% growth month over month really start adding up after a year. So that's the strategy I want you to implement. Now, if you need help implementing this strategy and you just want my team to do it for you, check out my ad agency, Neil Patel Digital. If you enjoyed this video, like it, share it, subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, just leave a comment. I'll answer it and help you out. Cheers and have a wonderful day.